Mr. Brown. Seventh inning. Stand up.
Gosh, seventh inning already, huh? Well, here I go.
That's right, Mr. Brown. We'll need all the luck we can get to win this game.
Well, we may have some right now. The heavy end of the batting order is up.
What do you mean, the heavy end? According to the program, the beginning of the order is up.
Well, Elmer, that's just what I mean. You see, all managers pick the batting order with just one idea. To score a run using the first four or five men, if possible.
Well, I don't follow you.
You see, the first fellow on the list is called the leadoff man. And this one, incidentally, is a great leadoff man. He's got a good eye, won't hit at a bad ball. He's fast, good base runner, and a good hitter, even though he's not a slugger. In other words, Elmer, it's his job to get on base and then be able to get home. With a little help, of course.
They walked him.
Hey, we got somebody out. We got a man on first and no one out.
Well, what about the second hitter?
Well, he's usually a pretty good hitter. Must be able to bunt. Got to be fast. A left-handed hitter, if possible. You see, a right field hitter has a better edge with a man on first. The runner naturally holds the first baseman to his bag, which leaves a better opening for a ground ball to right field.
Oh, boy! Wow, what a swell bunt! Right along the first baseline.
Yes, sir. That's one out.
Yeah.
With a tying run on second. Now the third man's up.
Well, what's he supposed to do?
Well, they usually pick the third man because he hits, but regularly. I suppose his batting average for safe hits is the highest of anyone on the team.
Oh, that's
a tough
one. Gee, I never thought the third baseman would hold that line drive.
He really hit it, didn't he?
Yeah.
But he did hold it, and almost, I said, almost, got the man before he could get back to second. But he got back, and after all, that's what counts.
What about the next batter?
Well, Elmer, the fourth man in the batting order is what is called the cleanup man. He has to hit a long ball, have power. He must be able to score a man from first or second. That's why he's called the cleanup man.
Oh, gosh, then we're sunk. Because the next guy up has struck out three times already today.
Now, wait a minute, Elmer. That's over and in the past. Each time up, it's a new story with a batter. He's got to forget what has happened and think only of what's going to happen.
Gee, well, why is he swinging three bats? Is that because he's left-handed?
Oh, Elmer, no. No, son, the important thing in batting is balance. And by swinging a lot of bats and then just using one, it seems lighter and easier to control. He really hit that one, didn't he?
Yeah.
Too bad it went foul. You see, when he swings, he hits a lot with the left hand. That gets power into it. And he steps into the ball and follows through with his swing. And right now, I want to tell you that when you choose a bat, make sure it's not too heavy for you. Find a bat you like and stick to it. And notice, Elmer, that all cleanup men swing from the very end of the bat. They couldn't do that if their bat was too heavy.
Oh, I see.
And Elmer, if you want to be a good batter, you must learn to meet the ball solidly, squarely. Keep your eye on the ball. It doesn't have to be a long swing. You can develop power later. Never hit off your heels.
What do you mean, off your heels?
Well, don't step back when you hit. Pulling in your stomach and throwing your hips back, that, Elmer, is a sure sign of an amateur. Now you know what cleanup means.
Gee, Mr. Brown, I sure do.
Yes, sir. But remember this, Elmer. Have fun playing ball. And don't take it too seriously. Work like the dickens to be the best. But if you're not, then have fun trying to be the best. And as I always say, yuckahoola hickey doola.